Welcome to this video tutorial on how to enter fractions in the TI84 graphing calculator. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you two methods for entering a fraction in the TI84 graphing calculator. The first method uses the alpha key. The alpha key is located in the first column on the left side of the calculator. It is the third button from the top. When you select the alpha key, you are telling the calculator that you want to use a secondary function, and you want to use the secondary function that is written in green above the next button you select. So, to enter a fraction, we are going to use a secondary function located above the Y is equal to button. The Y is equal to button is located in the first row of buttons below the main window, and it is the very first button on the left. The secondary function we'll use is called F1. Let's try entering the fraction 1/2. First, select the alpha button. Then, select y is equal to access the F1 function. Notice that a menu appears. Now, if a menu does not appear on your calculator, then your calculator is not programmed with this option. You will have to use the other method for entering a fraction, and I'll show you the other method in a moment. But if you do see a menu, notice that the first option says N over D. The N stands for numerator and the D stands for denominator. This is the option we'll use to enter a fraction. So select option 1 by pressing the number 1 button on your calculator. The calculator displays a fraction and the blinking cursor is prompting you to enter a value for the numerator. Let's enter the number 1. Use the down arrow on the directional pad to move your cursor to the denominator of the fraction. Enter 2. You may want to move your cursor to the right side of the fraction by using the right arrow on the directional pad. This way, if you want to add 5 to the fraction, you are already on the right side of the fraction and you just need to press the plus sign and then 5. Now select Enter. The Enter button is located in the bottom right corner of the calculator. The answer, 11 over 2, is displayed in the window to the right side of the problem. Let's try the other method. The second method for entering a fraction uses the parentheses symbols. The parentheses symbols are located above the 8 and 9 keys on your calculator. Let's enter the fraction 1/2 again. Now select the open parentheses symbol, which is above the 8 key, type the number 1, select the division sign, type the number 2, and then select the closed parentheses symbol above the 9 key. By putting parentheses around the fraction 1/2, you are forcing the calculator to see 1/2 as a fraction. To add 5, just select the plus sign and then 5. Now select Enter. The calculator returns an answer in decimal form, 5.5. To change this answer to a fraction, select the Math button, which is located below the Alpha button, then select option 1 by pressing the number 1 or just selecting Enter. In the window, you'll see this expression, ANS and FRAC, with an arrow in between. ANS stands for answer, so the calculator will take the last answer displayed in the window, which in this case is 5.5. The arrow means convert to, and FRAC refers to fraction. So this expression tells the calculator to take the last answer and convert it to a fraction. Select Enter again, and the fraction form of our answer, 11 over 2, which is equivalent to 5.5, is displayed in the window. I hope this video helped, and thanks for watching.